call it. So today I'm going to be talking about vapor coolant spray, or you can also call it cold spray, whatever you want. Some of the indications of vapor coolant spray would be muscle spasm, trigger points, or decreased range of motion. Some of the precautions of vapor coolant spray would be to avoid improper technique, or you could cause frostbite. Also, ethyl chloride is extremely flammable. If inhaled, it could cause general anesthetic. Some of the contraindications of vapor coolant would be cold hypersensitivity, vasospastic disorders, and if you're treating upper extremity, you gotta be careful with the eyes, so you have to make sure you protect the athlete's eyes. Also, uncovered wounds is a contraindication, and contraindications relating to passive stretching and acute or post-surgical injury is also a contraindication of vapor coolant spray. Okay, some of the physiological effects of vapor coolant spray would be decreased of like sensitivity of the cutaneous nerve receptors, decreases pain, and it also breaks the pain spasm pain cycle.
So, hey, my name is Paula, so I'm going to be applying the vapor coolant cold spray on you today. Is that a comfortable position you're at?
Yes.
Okay, so for that you got to make sure that the sensation is good. There's no open wounds. Check circulatory status, and you gotta make sure she's looking away for, so to protect her eyes or just in case anything. You gotta hold the vapor coolant at about 12 inches away from the skin and at a 30 degree angle from perpendicular to the skin. And you gotta make sure you apply distal to proximal about 3 to 4 times. So. Okay, so after you apply the vapor coolant spray, you just make sure there's no irritation, there's no burn, and she has no allergic reaction to it.